New York. Gotham. The concrete jungle.
Good morning.
The city that never sleeps. The Big Apple. City of champions. Another typical Tom Farrell day. Or so I tell my parents. So maybe I'm not New York's hottest bachelor. I'm by no means quick, but I'm quite adept at finding the perfect comeback when I'm home by myself, hours later. Why don't you drink up, little elf? I rent a one-bedroom apartment. Like most unmarried guys, I'm not a good cook, but I'm resourceful. I guess I have my own certain style.
I have a job I like. A&R rep at a major record label. That's artists and repertoire. I don't call the shots, but I have signed 12 consecutive bands, also known to my colleagues as The Streak. The Pipes, Violet Moon, Scab Inferno. Maybe you've heard of them, maybe not. None of my bands has gone platinum yet, but I'm patient. Great music always finds its following. You're probably wondering why hasn't some lucky woman made an honest man out of me? Well, so far I've played the field and the field won. Actually, I do have a girlfriend, Gabby. She's beautiful, smart, loves music. And did I mention? She's beautiful. Of course, she needs a little help with the dancing. What's she doing with her arms?
This is my circle of friends. My best girlfriend, Bran. She's a friend who's a girl, not a girlfriend. Never mind. That's Mike, my oldest buddy, Mike, who's married to my sister, Karen. My very pregnant sister, Karen. This is Jake, ex-pro athlete and shooter. Man about town. Good friends all, whose mere presence in my life serves to remind me of all the things I've yet to accomplish.
You see, when I was a boy, I had this idea of what my life would be like at this age. Great job, perfect wife, litter of kids, endless riches. Well, 1 out of 4 is not bad. And my life is my own, which is what matters, right? No one tells me what to do. No one. I'm the king of me. Now, if you'll excuse me, I gotta take this call.
Hey, Mom.
Yeah.
Welcome to Goliath Records. It's where some of the top A&R reps in history have worked. And what does an A&R rep actually do? Well, I fight crime. Crime being, in this case, really bad music. Because for every bad band you hear on the radio, there are a million worse bands trying to get on the radio. So it's my job to listen to this crap so that you don't have to. And listen, and listen. I'm the guy who flies to Buffalo, Des Moines, or in this case, Monroe, Michigan, to stand in a smoky, stinky sauna of a dive and try and find the next great band.
Do I seem familiar? I've crossed you in hallways 1,000 times.
What is this kid? 8?
No more camouflage. I want to be exposed and not be afraid to fall.
Oh, I'm gonna must. Man, listen to that melody. You see, most of the time, you leave a club disappointed, or if the band is exceptionally bad, suicidal. But every once in a while, the music just speaks to you.
For you, I will.
And thus begins the courting, cajoling, and selling. All for the shot to pour a ton of money into an unknown entity with the blind prayer that the rest of the world will hear the same magic you do.
I muster every ounce of confidence I have. For you, I will.
Goliath Records is the perfect place for you, Wayne. We believe in you. We love your sound. We'll fight any fight we have to get you out there. Isn't that right, Eli?
You're going to be bigger than Beck.
But you're Wayne, and we'll make sure you keep your Wayne-ness.
Do you guys like cereal? What kind of cereal do you like to eat?
Grape nuts.
Grape. Well, I go for
Frosted Flakes. Frosted Flakes. And also sometimes Lucky Charms.
In other words, you like choice, right? See, we are meeting with other labels and we're shopping around for the best deal. And then we will make our choice. And we will go home with a closed deal.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Wayne.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks,
man. Ma'am.
You too.
Good meeting you.
Hey, either of you guys know Sid Vicious's real name?
John Simon Ritchie. But his friends called him Sly.
I can't believe you, Mr. Streak, are still chasing that prepubescent Muppet.
And I can't believe a plate of sushi is $150.
It's Toro. That's the Rolls Royce of sushi.
It's fish, raw fish. Okay, have you heard Wayne's lyrics? Kid's a genius.
Don't see it. Next.
What are you talking about? You don't see it.
Eli?
Okay.
Tom?
Hey, Jeff. How are you?
Well, pretty good. You don't happen to have an extra ticket for the P. Diddy thing, do you?
Actually, you know what? I gave my tickets to Eli.
Sorry, dude. I can't help you.
Hey, no worries. No worries. Catch you on the flip side, right?
All right. See you, Jeff. What are you talking about? You have tickets? How come you didn't give me your tickets?
Because I'm sleeping with his girlfriend. It'd be bad form.
You sleep with Jeff's girlfriend? Jeff. Jeff. Nicest guy in the music industry, Jeff. Why?
I didn't think I could get her.
Try that again.
Got a mouse in the house. Got a little guy on me. Come on, Tommy. Come on, baby. Tommy, I'm open. I'm open. Tommy, I'm open.
And then he says it like I'm supposed to high-five him. Hey, I'm sleeping with another guy's girl. Great times, you know? And what are the rules on this? Should I tell Jeff or what?
You know what? I make it a rule to never, ever sleep with another man's woman. Normally, of course. But still, there's that cone of silence. You know, what is said between men stays there, brother. You know, it's like doctor-patient confidentiality. You cannot tell Jeff.
You can't tell him.
No. No. You sleep with another man's woman, you should be shot. You tell him.
Tell him.
Tell him.
There are exceptions. What about Chloe?
Chloe.
How well do you know this guy, Jeff?
We broke band together. He left to start his own label, but Jeff's a good guy.
I'm gonna rule a shooter on this one. You gotta be Switzerland.
Whoa. Sublime.
She does take care of herself.
If you like that kind of thing.
Jake Dunn? I was at Shea when you cleared the bases with that stand-up triple in the 2000 series.
Glory days.
I'm Debbie. We met. Remember you autographed my bra?
34C, sexy white lacy thing.
Well, 34D now. But yeah, that was me. I can't believe you remember. Hey, you wanna go grab a drink sometime?
Debbie, I just got out of a relationship. I'm kinda taking a break from the whole dating thing.
Okay.
Debbie, I just got out of a relationship, and I'm kind of taking a break from the whole dating thing.
I'm strictly in a blonde phase right now.
Oh, is that what you call it?
You're killing us, you know
that?
You're
killing us, and you're married to my sister.
Yes.
I had this patient give birth today. Labor was 16 hours, and the husband sets up his CD player and blasts Metallica.
That is so rude.
I know.
Out of curiosity, what album?
Does it matter?
Well, Ride the Lightning is a great album.
Ride the Lightning?
That's what I just said.
I always go with Tom on music.
Thank you, Mike.
Mike, if you even think about playing anything other than what Karen wants, you are so fired.
You can't fire him. He doesn't work for you.
You're fired, too.
I'm thinking Tori Amos.
What?
Uh-oh.
No. No vagina music. That is way too on the nose. I was thinking about something with a little more edge. Maybe, you know, Billy Joel.
Listen, we don't want to frighten the baby.
You know what, Mike? I'll take care of it. I'll make a childbearing mix. You'll love it.
Oh, we could use my music and put some of my spoken word on it. It'll help distract Karen from the seemingly endless agonizing pain of childbirth.
Gabby's great, you know? She's great. I really like that. And she, What? What?
Wow, Tom, she's great.
Right.
Yeah, no question.
Come on. I mean, that woman is so defective, you can return her and get your money back. Not to mention, she wants to marry you.
Defective. She's unique, is what she is. She doesn't want to marry me. For your information, Gabby is against the idea of marriage.
She told you that?
Yeah, she told me that.
I don't believe in marriage. It's a feckless convention imposed by society. It has nothing to do with love.
Note to self. Get dictionary. Look up feckless.
I hate to ask a stupid question here, but what is the upside in dating a woman who doesn't believe in marriage?
Upside? What's the downside?
Gabby's a free spirit. She lives life her own way, you know? It's like one of the many things we have in common. That's not true. Sorry.
I hate to be the one to break this to you, but you and that woman in there have absolutely nothing in common.
Get out. We have plenty in common.
Really?
Yeah.
What?
Both love music.
And?
Both love music.
And?
We have plenty in common, trust me.
Oh, air supply? Are you kidding me? As if it isn't hard enough digesting vegetarian food as it is.
Air supply is awesome.
Oh my God.
You're such a music snob.
Disliking bad music does not make me a snob.
So our musical tastes aren't exactly in sync. She listens to Jewel and weeps while I prefer music. And Gabby's own music is so sappy and pretentious. You see, when I first met her, she wanted me to sign her. But a man must stick to his principles. Instead, I asked her out.
Would you pick up something for Karen's baby shower? Something off the registry, something no animal died to make, and no animal testing either. I'll be in the studio all day, and then I have yoga. Wheat balls?
No, I always sit this way. You know, you could always blow off yoga.
It centers me. You should try it sometime. Help you lose your edge.
I like my edge. It's what keeps me edgy.
You're never gonna propose to me, are you?
Yeah. What? No. I mean, I thought... What? I thought you didn't believe in marriage. You said you didn't believe in marriage. Is this a joke?
And there she goes. For those keeping score, when a woman asks if you ever plan to propose, the proper response probably isn't, is this a joke?
You did not say that. Are you on the drugs?
She was vehemently against the whole concept of marriage.
She is a woman in her 30s. A woman in her 30s who says that she isn't into marriage is like a guy saying he isn't into sex.
No, a guy saying he isn't into sex is like, see, that's never happened.
After all of these years and all of these train wrecks that you call relationships, have I taught you nothing? Really, I feel like a complete failure.
At what point did this become about you?
It's always about me. Don't forget that. So here is the $10 question.
Yeah.
Gabby wants to tie the knot. Do you see yourself settling down with her?
Oh, why don't you just say, do you see yourself compromising the rest of your life? And why do I have to plan that far into the future? And why can't she be happy with what we have right here, right now?
Silly, silly man. We're not 20 anymore.
I know.
For a woman, now is the future. Too late's just around the corner.
It's a nice turn of phrase. If I'm ever late, I might use it.
But you mean when you're late?
I'm holding last month's shipping statements. Sales are down, profits are down, the music industry sucks.
Sorry, Phil. Sorry.
The rules have changed, and now we have to change. You better start thinking outside the box, and I don't mean just outside, but far, far away from the box. Imagine the box is infected with some kind of terrible flesh-eating disease. That's how freaking far I want you from it. If our numbers don't improve, I will fire people. Any questions?
Phil's right.
I mean, Phil is, he's right. It used to be about the music. Now what's it about? Marketing? Marketing to 10-year-old girls or tying the album to the latest Vin Diesel flop. Anyone can sign the latest lip-sync and Ashley Simpson flavor of the minute, right? I mean, Hanson. Remember Hanson? But where are the new classics? You know, where are the things that we're going to be talking about 30 years from now? Dylan, Clash, Stones, Pistols, Run DMC, Aretha, Smokey. You know, where are those things? You know, and you know, so what if we're not like some giant chart-topping label? That shouldn't be our goal. Money shouldn't be our goal. You know what our goal should be? Finding the music and putting the music out there that will change people's lives, because that is the power and the beauty of music. And that's what I believe.
Can we focus on that? Believe me, people, the rest will take care of itself.
Tom. Listen to you, I saw myself as a kid, full of convictions, ideals, piss and vinegar. Every word you said was precisely the opposite direction this company is going. A giant chart-topping label is our goal. In case you forgot, I discovered Hanson.
Ouch.
Oh, and you're fired.
Now fired?
Within the next 15 seconds.
I'm just gonna cut my losses and go now.
Co-ed baby shower. No, man.
No.
What sadistic mind thought this up, Tom?
Trying to figure out if women actually believe we'd enjoy this, or it's payback.
Definitely payback.
For sure.
Beer.
Hey, guys. Guys, isn't this great?
Come on, guys. Work with me. All we gotta do is get through the gifts, and we probably shouldn't cluster like this.
Whoa, she's not gonna open all of those gifts.
There are hundreds of them. Well, that's what you do at a baby shower. You stand around and watch women open gifts.
No.
And by the way, the number is 52.
You count it?
It's my feeble attempt at maintaining control. Can't give away all the power. Scatter!
Hey. You look lousy.
Yeah, I got fired.
You?
Yeah, fired.
Got fired?
Yeah.
But you're the guy.
I am.
You're the straight guy.
That's right.
The guy with the gold mirror. That is not right. Whose ass do I kick?
Whoa. Hey, easy on the ASS. Is that the baby in the belly? No cussing in front of the kid. How's Little Rocker doing anyway?
Off the record, baby in belly, fun. Baby coming out, not so much. I wouldn't go for a bottle of vodka or Valium. Tom, what if I make a terrible mother?
You're not gonna make a terrible mother. You've been mothering me since the day I was born, and look at me. That's a bad example. What I mean is, you're gonna make a great mother.
Oh, shh, don't tell my cousin any of this.
Isn't this great?
Yes,
hey, Mike.
Honey.
Oh, there he goes.
Oh, brain and white at Scott. I mean, he couldn't come, some water main burst, and he had to cover the story, but still, the gesture was made.
Well, they are dating.
Two dates, and she invites him to a baby shower? You blew it, buddy.
Brandon and I are friends, but I have a girlfriend.
Yeah. Gabby?
Yeah.
Oh, please, Tom, the woman's a cook. You two have the shelf life of a carton of milk. She's not good enough for you, which is why you like her. No long-term threat. So tall of you. Gabby!
Hey.
My favorite happy couple.
Karen, you're gonna love your gift. Tom got it from your aunt.
Really? Shopping for baby. Dylan.
The essential Dylan.
The essential Dylan.
Hey, isn't this great?
Dylan.
I cannot believe we gave your sister a Bob Dylan CD for her baby shower.
Okay, not any Bob Dylan CD, the essential Bob Dylan. Every song he ever recorded. Why, you think I should have gone greatest hits? I should have gone greatest hits. More accessible, less intimidating. I should have gone greatest
hits. Will you stop with the CDs? This isn't working.
What isn't working?
We're incompatible.
What?
I'm a vegetarian, you worship meat. I love yoga, you like any sport that involves a ball. You hate my music. My music is who I am.
I do not hate your music. Never once have I said that. I hate her music.
I can't stand her music. She's awful.
Have you thought about what I said last night? Has the thought of marrying me crossed your mind?
Lie, man. Tell her yes.
No. But that doesn't mean at some point it couldn't cross.
No, Tom, it's music first for you. And second, and third. Always has been. There are more important things. I need someone who's ready to settle down with me. You know, I've always believed that you gotta give up something to get something. I thought you were the something I got. Now I realize you're the thing I've gotta give up. What they say, when you love someone, set them free. Bye, Tom.
Wait, did she just quote Sting in the middle of breaking up with me? So I stood there, shattered, a broken man, and then it dawned on me. I'm single.
to never having to suffer through downward facing dog again. Watch as much sports as you want.
Eat a bacon burger without ridicule.
And if Giselle Bundchen should ever happen to hit on me, I'm my friends, I'm available.
It's Bundchen. Giselle Bundchen.
It's Bundchen.
It's
just one. Cheers, guys.
Cheers.
The man loses his job and girlfriend back to back, and he's still out drinking. That shows strength of character.
Thank you.
Welcome back, brother. You found your escape hatch. Well done.
Unless, of course, you want to marry the woman.
Wait a minute. You guys are romanticizing this whole single thing just a little, don't you think? I mean, marriage does have its benefits.
So do health insurance plans.
Mike, I'm not against marriage with the right woman, but until she comes along, I am free to play the field.
Right? Grab your bat and play ball?
Don't say grab your bat.
The man's right.
My bad.
Yeah, right, whatever. Look, Tom, if this is too early for you and you need some time to heal, you just say the word.
Yeah, you know what, Mike? Maybe you're right. Maybe it is too soon.
How's now?
Now's good.
Woo!
Cool.
Hi
there.
You're not one of those attached creeps, are you? You are single.
Am I single? Oh, no, I am single. I am single. The fact is, I am so single, I am singular. Freshly single, too. Just ended a five-month relationship an hour ago, you know? Gabby and I, done. Look, that's her name. You do like her. She's nice, funny. Love, sex, wildcat, dynamo.
Man has not lost his touch.
Mm-mm.
Does have talent.
Nothing wrong with great sex. I mean, especially the way Gabby would do it, you know? He yell my name, you know, but it just doesn't seem right that it's gone now, you know, like, it just seems like we deserve more, you know, and the more I think about it, it seems dead wrong, you know, we should, I don't know, deserve more, deserve something better, deserve a second chance, I think, don't you think?
Tom Farrell is back. You know, that was the most pathetic display of being back in the game I've ever seen. So she can recommend a couples therapist?
What does that mean?
I'm proud of you, Tom. You miss Gabby. It's okay to say it.
Miss Gabby?
Go ahead and say it.
No. You don't miss Gabby.
I don't miss Gabby.
No, you miss the idea of Gabby.
I miss the idea, yeah. And I didn't just eat the pepperoni off Jake's pizza. I ate the idea of the pepperoni.
Gabby's a short-term solution to a long-term problem. You're looking for Mrs. Tom. You're one. Your destiny. I'm out of cliches.
Well, so what if I am? What's wrong with that?
Well, like we told you, Gabby isn't it. Or isn't her.
It's her. Dangling or not, I thought Gabby was the one.
Tom, every time you start to date a woman, you say she's the one. You always have the best intentions.
You have the worst follow-through.
You do this every time.
I do not do that every time.
Yes, you do. Every time.
I do?
You do it every time.
I tell you guys I'm starting a new label?
I think it's a great idea. You've always dreamed of starting your own label, and now you won't lose weight.
Yeah, I know. It's good. It's gonna be difficult too. I have to find a distributor, money for marketing, promotion. But you know what? Why not? You ain't got nothing? You got nothing to lose.
Clapton.
Dylan.
I'll get one of these days.
Right,
well. Timing's perfect on the label thing. No Gabby, no job, no distractions, and you've got the golden ear. No one's better.
Well, you know, at least there's one thing in my life I'm good at, because clearly my relationship skills suck.
Maybe if you stopped chasing after emotionally unstable vocalists.
You're not a vocalist. Lola played drums.
You can't keep swinging from branch to branch forever, Tom. Eventually, you're going to have to pick one and settle down.
Oh, come on. What is it with you and the selling? I'm not going to just pick any old random branch. It has to be a smart, funny, pretty, sexually adept branch, the perfect branch.
You keep looking for the perfect branch, you're going to end up one lonely monkey.
Coffee every day. Come on, get down.
Hey, hey. Tom Farrell back from the dead.
Yeah, listen, about yeah. Wayne, okay? All the calls yes. Now have to come to my home
yes.
Phone number, okay?
Yes.
You make
yes.
Sure. Switchboard notes.
I
told them
I
make
will
sure.
Call you. I will.
Right, okay, but the calls from Wayne have definitely. To come. The calls from Wayne have to come to my house.
Ian. Good. Thank you.
not let Eli sign Wayne. I will not let him sign. I'm signing Wayne. I will not let that guy win. Another one, Jack.
Not to sound like unsupportive guy, but don't you need an infrastructure, a business plan, financing?
Eli's got a whole company behind him. You got, well, not a whole lot.
You got nothing.
How do you plan on competing in that game?
Change the game.
Nice. I like it. How?
No idea.
No, I'm serious. You, your own label? I mean, that's a fantastic idea.
And are you sure you're not just obsessing over Wayne because now you might not get him?
I'm not obsessing over Wayne because I might not get him. I'm obsessing over Wayne because he's brilliant.
Tom, you do have a habit of wanting things you can't have.
What else is there to want?
Thank you.
Look, I myself am perfectly content with the life that I've built. Although I do look at you guys sometimes and wish I was single again. Don't you guys ever look at me and wish you were married?
You out of your mind?
Not a shot now.
You've gone to the other side.
Although my entire career in the majors, I wished I was playing pro football. It's a dream of mine since I was a boy.
That's Grant's Law.
Grant's Law?
Hugh Grant. The man had the hottest, sexiest, most beautiful woman waiting at home for him, right? And what does Hugh do? He picks up some cut-rate whore off of Hollywood Boulevard. I mean, come on. If that's not ultimate proof that we as men can never, ever be satisfied, I don't know what is.
Hey, look, guys, I've been married 6 times, okay? As soon as you think you found the right one, there's another one right around the corner.
That's Grant's Law.
I had the perfect girl. Her sister is even more perfect. So I slept with her.
That's Grant's Law.
I want to be a woman.
How you doing? I brought you lunch.
From your pocket.
Yeah, shut up and eat. So what's up?
Well, I miss you.
Miss you.
Eli moved me to his desk. What an ass.
He's an ass.
Rumor has it you're starting your own label.
Yeah, and trust me, when I can afford to hire you back as an assistant, you're hired. But until then, I'll take a spy. So what's the deal?
50 grand advance, $500,000 per record.
Has Wayne responded yet?
Not yet. But Eli's picking him up at 10 a.m. tomorrow in a stretch for a helicopter tour of Manhattan.
A helicopter? What an ass.
Yes. He's hoping to close the deal. I just faxed this itinerary to the hotel.
Who's my little double-crosser?
I prefer the term mole.
So if Eli wants to play dirty to get Wayne, I can play dirty. No, I'm not going to lie or betray anyone. Just fully embrace who I am and meet the kid on his level.
What's going on? How you doing?
Hey, where's Eli?
Eli, yeah. Eli, yeah, he couldn't make it. He caught a bad shrimp or something. So let's get going.
I said I wasn't going to lie, but bending the truth, that's acceptable, right? So I gave Wayne the Tom Farrell New York City rock and roll tour. We started with the Chelsea Hotel. Hendrix slept there, Joplin, Dylan too. So, you know, good times. Led Zepp, Physical Graffiti. Nice. Then on to the alley that Dylan used for his classic Subterranean Homesick Blues. And finally, the mecca of underground rock. The cradle of punk and new wave, ladies and gentlemen, CBGBs. Welcome to the Inner Sanctum. The Ramones, Talking Heads, Lou Reed, all played on these hallowed grounds and did God only knows what back here. We channeled the spirits of the rock and roll gods as we launched into a vicious contest of dueling guitars. Two virtuosos, mano a mano. Well, mano a kiddo. I called upon all my innate guitar prowess, my extensive years of strumming experience, my memorized catalog of classic licks, riffs, and chords. And still, the kid kicked my butt.
Not Eli.
Claire.
Claire.
Claire, a groupie, girlfriend?
Friend.
Ah.
Yeah, she's been dating this meathead jock.
So they still have meathead jocks, do they? Yeah, but now evolution would have taken care of meathead jocks.
So how about you?
What about me?
You married?
No, I'm just now out of a relationship.
What happened?
it's a complicated
complicated adult thing.
Yeah.
So she wants to settle down, and you're too afraid. Now that she's left, you want her more than ever. Yeah, the same thing happened to me. It took me 6 weeks to realize she wasn't the one, and I did. I'm a better man for it. Listen.
You got words for that?
Yeah.
Can't always give.
Oh, boy. Yeah, it's I'm sorry, it's late. I wanted to talk. Oh, is Scott up there? You know what? I don't know. It's not my business. But is he up there? No, you know what? I don't want to know.
How are you?
I'm fine. Good. Solid gold.
It's too late for that. You have 14 seconds to tell me the truth starting now.
Okay, here's the thing. A few days ago, I had a job. I had a girlfriend. I was on the verge of signing Wayne all by myself. Now I got to compete with all these other bloodsuckers like Eli. And I don't have a job, and I don't have a girlfriend. I'm trying to be this major label without the major and without the label, I might add. And I think I would like to go back there.
I don't understand why you would want to be with someone who doesn't want to be with you.
Well, are you talking about Gabby or are you talking about Wayne?
You're one of the smartest people I know. How can you be so dumb?
Well, it's really a lot easier than you think.
Do you want it straight or sugar-coated?
Oh, you couldn't sugar-coat an ice cream sundae.
Nice turn of phrase. Thanks. Tom, I will defend you to anyone on this planet, but between you and me, you have this thing where you only think about yourself.
Well, in fairness, I do spend the bulk of my time with me.
I'm serious. And here's the sugar coating. You only want Gabby because it works for you. You weren't even that into her before.
Well.
And you only want Wayne because it's good for you. You're not thinking about what's good for Gabby or Wayne.
Look, next time, give it to me straight.
I wouldn't say it if I didn't know you could take it. I hate being the bad guy.
Fran.
Tom.
That was a lot longer than 14 seconds.
Good night.
Night.
Are you gonna sit on my stoop very long?
No, I'm leaving now.
Okay.
Right, whatever I did, it was an accident. Unintentional. Didn't do it on purpose, promise.
The guys and I've been talking.
Oh, seven scariest words I've ever heard.
Who are you, Rain Man? Is I even a word?
No, it's a conjunction.
Yeah,
it's
not. It's a great
thing. Yeah. I mean, it's
a word. It could be considered a pronoun because it does act as
a word. That's it. No, I'm going to go with conjunction.
Hey, you know, I have to actually get to Wayne's gig, so can we wrap this up?
Right. No. All right, listen, here it is. You want your own label, right? We love the idea. We want to help. Now, I can't personally bankroll an entire label, but I will put up $1 to get you started, my man.
I've got an extra room in my office. It's yours if you want it now.
I can get the word out at the paper. Any press you need. Anyway, you cover sports.
And leisure.
Boys. Group hug.
Saturday night, Wayne's gig. Here we go.
Hey, Johnny Mac, what's up?
Hey.
Hi. You didn't have to come.
Hi.
Well, it's a big night for you.
Ah, you look great.
Thanks. I'm meeting Scott later at some fancy soiree.
Scott, excellent.
How you feeling?
I'm feeling like a guy who's about to keep a streak alive. Excuse me one second.
Okay.
Mama. Hey, Jeff, how's it going? Hey, Vanessa, can I get a scotch and soda?
Don't ask. Girlfriend troubles.
Girlfriend? You got girlfriend troubles? So that's, thanks. That's sorry to hear that.
Yeah.
Hey. Hi. Mwah.
Julia, Liz, Meredith, me, Tom.
Hi.
Say something. Say something raucously bewitching.
Hey.
Hi. Beers, right?
Yeah.
Thanks. So we're going to find a table.
Enjoy the show.
Meet you.
Hey, kudos on finding this Wayne kid.
Yeah, she's, yes, thanks. You know, I got lucky. Heard the right demo. You know how it goes, but now I gotta get the kid to sign.
Hey, it takes more than luck, man. We both know that. I mean, look at your ear. You're a good guy with a fantastic ear. In this business, you're an inspiration, an anomaly, a decent, honest.
Eli's doinking your girlfriend.
I knew it, that jackass.
He's a jackass. Look, Jeff, I wanted to tell you, I just didn't know what the rules were on something like this, you know, when to tell, who to tell.
Technically, you have to get drunk with somebody at least twice before you own that information.
Is it twice?
Yes.
Twice. Look at it this way. If your girlfriend likes Eli, she's not good enough for you. Catch you later.
Hey, figured I'm back. I called it, didn't I? Whatever happens, we're cool, right?
Whatever happens, you'll never be cool. Right?
Hi, folks. How you doing? Good night.
Hey, how you doing?
Look, if it were up to me, we would be signed to Goliath by now, but he wants to wait till after the gig. He thinks some people get him live and some don't.
Since you and Eli are both here, I guess we'll see.
Look, here's the deal. I can't match Goliath financially. I can't give you that, but what I can give you, I can give you my word that I will be at every session, every rehearsal. I will handpick every sound engineer. I'll be able to tell you what years the Fender Stratocasters were the best or what the analog boards sound like versus the digital. In short, I will eat, breathe, sleep Wayne, because Wayne will be everything I have.
Well, he's everything we have, too, but I know with these record labels, there's a million acts, and we only have one Wayne.
I get it.
Hey, I'm Wayne. Thanks for coming out here tonight. Thanks for doing it.
You like the adrenaline rush, just a little too much. You go from day to day, hand to mouth, and wonder why you're unsatisfied. 'Cause love is a marathon. You can't always get what you want from everyone. Slow.
Don't sign with me.
What?
Don't sign with me. Go with an established label.
Wayne likes you, Tom.
Thanks. You're not exactly making this any easier. Listen, I can't give Wayne what he needs right now. Maybe in a year or so, I'll get my label up and running. I would kill to work with Wayne, but right now, you should go with an established label. That's what's best for Wayne.
You're just a cat chasing your tail.
Your son's an amazing talent.
Something might lessen. 'Cause love is a marathon. You can't always give. Slow down.
You let him go, didn't you? Go. Scott's waiting. You did good tonight.
up.
Hey, it's Jeff. Do you have any free time?
Hang on, Jeff. Let me check my book. Yeah, today works for me. Okay.
See, I knew if we stuck with him to the third album, they'd pop. That's great. I'm sorry to hear about your streak.
Yeah, you know what they say. Need to be broken. It's still good.
Just start a new one.
Yeah.
So, what you did? Giving up Wayne. It's pretty cool. Everybody's talking about it.
How do you know about that?
Wayne told me. I signed him this morning.
You signed Wayne? Wayne? Adolescent Wayne?
Yeah, when I heard him last night, it was like, wow. And, you know, and then I found out Eli was in the hunt. Let's just say it made signing the kid that much sweeter. You know, what I wouldn't pay to see the look on Eli's face when he finds out.
Yeah. I can't believe you signed Wayne.
I was hoping you'd rep him. So is Wayne. The kid just loves you.
What's this now? What are you saying?
You want to start a new streak?
Offer me a job?
It'd be a step down in pay from Goliath. We're a little more mom and pop around here. And this is going to sound crazy, but I am not in this for the money.
What are you in it for?
Well, the music, of course.
Hi.
Hey, Tom, you remember Julia?
Yeah, we met at the slipper room last night, right?
We did. Maybe.
What do you got?
This is the band I was telling you about. From Phoenix. Nice seeing you again. Or meeting you. Take your pick.
You know, about that job, I guess I could give it a shot.
So does this work for you?
Well, a little dour, but sure. Geez, Jeff, you guys ever vacuum around here?
You know, I know you've been at this a while, but, hey, John.
Ooh. What's up,
John, this is Tom.
Hey, John, Tom Farrell.
Hey, Tom, how are you?
Nice to meet you.
It's good. You're A&R rep. It's just what we need around here, right?
Good. Actually, I'm making Tom the head of A&R. That would make him your boss.
Yeah, so go grab me a cup of coffee, will you? Kidding.
I guess I should talk to you about where you want to record Wayne.
Oh, slow down. He hasn't even punched his time card yet. I'm just showing him around the office.
I haven't even got a time card yet.
I'll see you around.
Nice to meet you. I'll get the coffee.
Yeah, thanks. Appreciate it. Good guy. Nice shirt.
Yeah.
Hey, I just got some of these, and if you want one, it's amazing. Think of it as a welcome gift.
What is it?
The essential Bob Dylan, every song you ever recorded.
Oh, they've released this already. Who knew? Thank you.
Welcome to the True Vinyl family.
Thank you. Before you jump to any conclusions, I did not take the job because of that sublime, glorious, beautiful, near-perfect Julia. Yes, it's always been a dream to start my own label, but a steady salary, benefits, health insurance, those are good things too. And if you noticed, I didn't even flirt with her. Not once. I'm exempt from Grant's Law. So bye-bye, Hugh. Hello, Tom.